good groups slash players. You finally found a group that does want to play your fantasy novel. Some even want to help you write a novel for real and get it published. They help bring it above mediocre. In the end, it was the best campaign you've ever hosted. How about you guys? Yeah, I had that same dream too. It was kinda sad when I woke up though. Hey, what's up everybody, I'm Scatterbray and welcome to another episode of D&D Green Text. Also, happy holidays. As always, enjoy! Party is guarding the site. Some of the PCs are paying attention to the woods. Suddenly, they hear a shrill war cry. Ah! And a loud whack. If the party goes to investigate, they find Don Quixote unconscious, Lance embedded in a nearby tree, a confused mole wandering the area. If party chooses to get ready for battle in the site, they are supposed to guard. Have this repeat X amount of times for suspense before Don Quixote appears there. He, depending on your decision, offers to train the characters. Daggers equals spoon. Axes equals broom. Etc. Silliness, referring to the PCs as squires or sable boys. Depending if you choose to let your player roll for it or if you roll for it to actually benefit them, up to you. I personally would give them a small boon. Don Quixote wears gear, but it's composed of kettles and such trash, strapped onto him. So they have no inclination to kill the character for loot. If they kill him, the kettle on his head is a +1 helmet. Remember to tell them about the beautiful painted flower patterns on the white but suited surface. Give him decent stats according to your party's level. Not good or great, just decent. He will refer to your party as goblins if engaged. If the party and this valiant knight interact peacefully, he wanders off quite quickly. His trail echoes with the sound of war cries as he fells yet another foe. If they became friends, let this valiant knight leave a gift. Maybe a sack of jewels, which are marbles, elixir of healing, which is a pot of Vaseline, maybe a stout shield, which is a chamber pot lid. Use your imagination. Include this item in a later encounter. Perhaps marbles can be used to open a puzzle? Before you can react, why do GMs keep pulling this shit? Same reason you keep making awful threads. Sage. Sage? I don't know. Because you are too slow to react fast enough. Before you can react, a strange mist rises around you and you fall unconscious. You wake up in a cell without your armor or weapons. So, what's the origin of centaurs in your setting, TG? 1,000 years ago, there lived a powerful fighter named Sir Helbrook. Helbrook was a general in the king's army and had never been defeated in battle. One cold autumn day, Helbrook and his men were sent to battle the armies of Calvary. Knowing they were outnumbered 20-1, Helbrook and his men decided to pray to the gods for assistance in battle. The gods, hearing their prayers, decided to bless them with powerful skills in battle. They were transformed into masters of combat, and in one attack, they dominated the opposing forces into surrender. Not one of Helbrook's men fell in battle. When they returned home, the king granted Helbrook and his men riches beyond their comprehension. After the Battle of Calvary, Helbrook settled down with his wife and children in a small farm in the outskirts of Neverwinter. 3 years later, Helbrook's wife found out he was the family horse. She left him, and he was stuck with his abomination of a child. So ends the tale of Sir Helbrook, the horse. I'm so disappointed of how that story ended. I mean, okay, maybe I'm not disappointed, but I was so certain it was going in a different direction for a while. Oh well. You have united the human, dwarven, and elven realms on the continent. You have driven the giants back to the northern wastes, the orc warbands to the great steppe, and allowed the lizardmen to war among themselves now that the leash cannibal in the Saunter Marshes are broken. Your wife is the local goddess of the heart and has given you 9 sons and 4 daughters, all of which are amazing leaders. Your eldest son has been mostly ruling in your name for the past few years, as you near the end of your life. You can feel yourself nearing the end a little more each day. As your youngest son returns from his triumph earned by slaying an ancient red dragon, you feel yourself dying. What are your last words to your children and court? What is the background music? I attack the king. My last words as I lay dying, my own knife in my chest. It's what my character would do. FPBP. I have no idea what the fuck FPBP means. If any of you knows, please enlighten me in the comments. Other than that, 9 sons and 4 daughters, all of which are amazing leaders. That's f***. We're facing a legit succession crisis. Gotta kill at least 6 of the sons while I still can. Amazing. This is how addicts are born. Bimi, fighting demon in hell. Diablo.mp4. Protected by 3 crystals. Break one and grab a chunk. Try to eat it. That halfling gnome calls me an idiot. Holier than the wizard laughs at the idea. Party laughing at my dumb action. You are now immune to slashing damage. It sh- My face when? Playing Dark Heresy on Irk back in 2008. Voice chat on Ventrilo. GM's betrothed returns from work earlier than expected. GM was one of the female players who lived in the same city he did. That player was apparently connected from their apartment, they had a tryst earlier that day. Giant fight ensues. Forgot to mute my microphone and began to laugh at the absurdity of it all. GM's betrothed refills her rage meter when she hears my voice, female laughter, accuses GM of amassing a harem. Domestic violence intensifies. What the f, dude? You can't just end the story there and not tell us what the f happened afterwards, Jesus Christ. A succubus will not let you pass through her room unless you beat her in a game. She will only play if the game seems fun. What's your challenge? Strip poker. That lusty thought won't resist a chance to be a slut. Also, assuming you're wearing adventurer garb and armor, she's only wearing at most 2-3 items of clothing. Easy win. Yeah, win. Because I was trying to pass the test and not fulfilling a dirty fantasy. Yeah. Burp lands on your shoulder. Whispers to you in a female human voice. You've always been good to me, Hector. Don't go to the market square tomorrow. Burp flies away and does burp things. Your name is not Hector. What do you do? I don't go to the market square tomorrow? I've heard this plot hook before, but I can't remember when. Must have been from a thread a couple of years ago. I'd go look it up and see if we know anything about it from then. Yeah, I've posted it before. Be me. Be Bass Striker, level 5 human fighter. Running TOA and get to the guardian of the Black Orchid. Our NPC has been hypnotized by a woman with snake hair. Bargain with snake woman for black magic flower. Offer 1,000 gemstones from robe of many items. My face when she accepts. Go to live with flower. NPC decides she wants to stay. Try to force her to leave, but the snake woman gets hostile. Initiative.wav. Have plus 2 dex. Roll initiative. Natural1.gif. Hedge plan. Rest of the party not looking at snake woman to avoid petrification. All roll with disadvantage. Baz's turn.x. Go to the corner of the room. Inspect barrel. Use action to open up barrel. Barrel is empty. Perfect. DM thinks I waste turn in combat looking for loot. Pick up barrel and walk towards the snake woman. Party understands. DM doesn't get it. Action surge. Lift barrel above my head and turn around. Look Medusa directly in the eye and pass DC 15 con save. Slam barrel down onto Medusa's head. Roll 17. MFW, Medusa's face when, she rolls a 9 dex save. Pick related. Girdle of femininity / masculinity. This broad leather band appears to be a normal belt used commonly by all sorts of adventurers, but of course, it is magical. If buckled on, it will immediately change the sex of its wearer to the opposite gender. Its magical curse fulfilled, the belt then loses all power. The original sex of the character cannot be restored by any normal means, although a wish might do so. 50% chance, and the powerful being can alter the situation. An example, it takes a godlike creature to set matters alright with certainty. 10% of these girdles actually remove all sex from the wearer. Oh Gygax, you scoundrel. This reminds me of a player I had. Run an AL campaign. Guy walks up asking to play. Dude looked like a stereotypical thick glasses, balding hair, slight bit overweight, pencil thin mustache, etc. Ask him for his CS. When he gave it to me, I noticed the picture was of an elf girl. Thought to myself he was going to be playing his waifu. Prepared myself for cringe. To my surprise, his character was decently balanced. On top of that, the player was also very polite and was open to any changes. Decided that I was going to approve of the character. Then I noticed the character's information. Name: Veronica. Race: Elf. Class: Bard. Gender: Male. At first, I thought he was referencing the old joke of "lol, male elves look like women." Turned out it wasn't a joke. The guy explained the character's background. How he was born a male. How he was raised to be a male. How he didn't feel like a male. How he wanted to be a female, but wasn't sure. It soon was apparent to me how passionate he was about this character. Almost as if he was this character. Once he was done, the table fell silent. Fast forward 3 weeks later. Veronica is kicking some ass with his fellow party members. No one gives a shit that he's not a physical female. Everyone is too busy having fun. Alright, that was it for this video. Thank you guys for watching, I hope you enjoyed it. Leave a like if you did and subscribe for more. Also, happy holidays. I'm not sure when exactly this video is gonna be up, but should be around Christmas time, before or after, probably. Hope you're gonna get what you wanted on Christmas. I don't know. This video is out, so that's like halfway of your gift, right? Okay, bad joke, okay. Anyway, thanks for watching. Also, thank you to all the Patreon supporters, whose names you can see on screen. If you wanna be a Patreon yourself, there's a link below. Also links to Discord and other social media. And yeah, that's it. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next time. Have a great day, bye!